accomplishments and hard work that has been taken in terms of elements. Lastly, I am nervous about this next chapter in life, and again, I was very nervous and I'm very nice to be able to speak in the first place. Sure, at that point, it's back in high school, but I've been living from here on out in the snowy ups and being my own children. I'm sure a lot of you really glad you feel the same way too. After you have been in other boardrooms and experiencing new places, meeting new people, trying new foods, or experiencing hardships you've never felt before, you will learn the leadership, the goal, or teachers to guide us in the right direction if that's not the scary, right? Nonetheless, you've made it this far, and I hope you continue to give you more points. As it ends today, I want to say congratulations, class of 2023, for me as a high school, the best class of the high school. Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors and pledge of allegiance and the sign singing amongst the stars and the banner. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to be followed by the singing of our national anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic from which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. student athletes will be the first in their immediate families to attend a college or a university. Born a natural athlete, William graduated from Hopewell High School with the class of 1970. He played basketball and football. He was always praised by his teammates and coaches for his sportsmanship, leadership, to step to a later stage in the future that we can make the next step for you. Thank you, Miss Taylor. Miss Moore, please stand. Thank you, Miss Hanson, stand. Please stand, women that decided to serve and retire. Thank you, Miss Moore. Miss Hanson, for all you've done for this school. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Ms. Alexis Evans, senior class to the stage. Good morning. I'm Alexis Evans, and I have an honor to introduce you, Dr. Martin. Dr. Martin said, "Thank you for meeting my interview as superintendent of Hopewell City Public Schools." It was during this time that she was named Virginia Superintendent of the Year in 2021. Former dean, she served 10 years as superintendent of Charlotte County Public Schools and 4 years as deputy superintendent of Mecklenburg County Public Schools. She has also served as director of instruction, coordinator of alternative education services, principal, and special education teacher. Additionally, she has experience in leading community services for adults with disabilities and teaching at the post-secondary level at Shenandoah University, Liberty University, South Carolina Community College, and the University of Virginia. Dr. Hickman is an active member of numerous professional organizations and has special interests and expertise in the areas of servant leadership and development, 21st century teaching and learning, organizational behavior and communication, project based learning, student discipline, alternative education, school safety, gang awareness, and parent education. Dr. Hickman has a bachelor of arts degree in special education and 2 master of science degrees, 1 in business administration, and 1 in education administration. She received her doctorate in education leadership, policy and foundations in 2012 from the University of Virginia. Thank you again, Vice President Dr. Martin Hickman. Thank you. Some of everything I have for you every year was thankful for. The most important thing to me is loving each of you. So, good morning, everybody, and congratulations and happy graduation day to the class of 2021. Let's give them a good over here. Graduates, obviously, this is a huge day for each of you. Parents, family members, friends, faculty, and staff, a wonderful celebration, a collective celebration of your own as well. It has been an absolute joy to have partnered with all of you in honoring and hearing these beautiful songs over the last 13 years. Class, it will be known that we are beyond excited for you and overwhelmed with pride. You all are starting your 5th grade when I came to Hopewell. And when I brought it to my nerves, I still have images of beginning frozen in my memory of those precious little elementary school students so eager to please and still very enthusiastic about learning. I say this every year. I wish we could just freeze the interviewing time and be right here with us, protected, controlled, free from harm, free from risk, free from this crazy world in which we currently live. But I know that's not possible. So I celebrate with you the wonderful foundation you have received from your families, as well as the preparation you have received from your teachers and your schools. And now I know you're ready for this big transition. heroes of this story. So what do you have to do? Release the next few minutes. This is to celebrate 12 magnificent gifts that you already have. You actually receive them when you reward. And audience, if you will help me reinforce them as a special and collective blessing that we can help give to these precious children and students, young adults, I'm sorry, today, I'll tell you what you want to need. And here we go. At the wondrous moment that each of you will mourn as you take your very first breath, a great celebration was held in the heavens, and 12 magnificent gifts were granted to each of you. The first gift was strength. Strength. You are strong. You can get through anything you face from this day forward. Audience, will you say it and repeat after me for our graduates after each gift? Graduates, you are strong. Audience, help me. You are strong. The second gift is beauty. You are beautiful. Just the way you are. Graduates, you are beautiful. Audience, help me. You are beautiful. The third gift is courage. You have confidence to get through anything the future holds for you. Graduates, you already have courage. Audience, you have courage. The fourth gift is compassion. You have a God-given duty to first love yourself and then serve others in need. Graduates, you already have compassion. Audience, you have compassion. The fifth gift was hope. No matter where this next season of your lives take you, there is always hope for a better tomorrow and goodness to come out of any situation. Graduates, you have hope. Audience, you have hope. The sixth gift was joy. From the moment you took your first breath, your heart was opened and filled with light. Joy will always come, even after the hardest days, and you will have modeled that in some of the most difficult times of your human lives. Graduates, you will find and choose joy. Audience, find and choose joy. Seventh gift is talent. You've already been gifted with special abilities and purpose. Use them to contribute to making a better world. Graduates, you are talented. Audience, you are talented. The eighth gift is imagination. Listen to this one. What you can and will accomplish will be directly influenced by what you envision and dream for the life you have ahead of you starting today. Graduates, you can become anything you can imagine. Audience, you can become anything you imagine. The ninth is respect. Friends, respect everything, all things, all people, life. You deserve it and we all need you. Expect it for yourselves and give it away. In the famous words of Aretha Franklin, graduates, respect yourself. Audience, respect yourself. The tenth gift is wisdom. As you take this next path to the amazing future ahead of you, the wisdom you have now will not only guide your way, it will lead you through knowledge and then to understanding. Graduates, you are prepared. Audience, you are prepared. We're almost there. The 11th gift, and the most important to me, graduates, is love. I wish I could really tell you and show you how much you are loved. If our hearts could speak collectively, we would blow the roof off of this venue. Look at the people here, and what you as the graduates to just look at all these people in this venue. Look at the faculty, look at your families, loved ones, wherever they sit this morning. You are loved, and you have been taught by all of us how to love. Graduates, you are loved. Audience, face of God, you are loved. agencies, we have Hopewell St. Public Schools, that can properly express our heartfelt sympathy to the families and to each of you. I don't know, we don't know why these things happen. And I acknowledge that it is becoming harder and harder to try to make sense of it, but let's know when these kinds of losses happen in our school community. However, while Texas life was cut shorter than any of us would have wanted, there is a greater plan for him. And I know that my constant prayer and many of yours has been envisioning him in heaven with God, already enjoying the wonder of that place that I wish for all of you one day. So maybe this year, this next part, this even more special and appropriate than has ever been for me. I started a tradition 18 years ago of getting each of the graduates an angel pen to display on their graduation gown. And I say this every single year. I admit the gift was more for me, and possibly there are less daddies and loved ones, family members, teachers that are here today to celebrate with them. I wanted a visual symbol of protection for each of them as they make their way through this world in which they officially send them today. This year has special, special significance because even without the pen that I have seen each of you wearing, I believe you already have a special angel watching over you, protecting each of you as you officially begin this next chapter of your lives. So in this case, the Lord has already answered my prayer in the class of 2023. That angel, we all know, is your friend and classmate. And fellow graduate, Cortez Chiva. I can play today like I do every graduation ceremony and have for 18 years with the special prayer. May you always have an angel by your side, by Douglas Cortez. May you always have an angel by your side, watching out for you and all the things you do. Reminding you to keep believing there will be brighter days, finding ways for your dreams and your wishes to all come true, giving you hope that is served as the sun, giving you strength and serenity as your guide. May you always have comfort and courage, and may you always have an angel by your side. Someone there to catch you when you fall, encourage your dreams, inspire your purpose, hold your hand, and help you through it all. In all of our days, our lives are always changing. Tears for all, as well as smiles. Along the road you've traveled, and will continue to travel, may the miles be a thousand times more lonely than they are alone. May they give you gifts that never, ever end. Someone wonderful to love, and a dear friend in whom you can confide. May you have rainbows after every storm. May you have hopes to keep you warm. And may you always have an angel by your side. Class of 2023, on behalf of every single person in this room and on the stage today, we love you, we are proud of you, and we will miss you. You will always hold a very precious place in our hearts, not just today, but always, a look like forever. We love you, friends. God bless you.
Thank you for that wave of affection. Pennsylvania, made a case for the Hopewell case. And that's where the Hopewell Supreme Court ruled that there was a standard case to make that first round of evidence to the public graduates. And the graduate is every one person who has accomplishments and consistent throughout these times of great hardship and tribulation. So may we celebrate our achievements in this school. Let's sing for you together. Coming out to us, grace our weaknesses, and for the night calls to issues. Let us come to thank and share with our class, to whom in the stands, let us not forget the sound of us. Let us see every setback as an opportunity for growth, and every success as a stepping stone to our greater achievements. As Mr. Churchill has said, success is not final, failure is not fatal, it is the courage that simply can kill us. If we get failed once, as far as we end, as we share with our lives, let us remember that it is our responsibility to seek knowledge and increase our experiences. Let us exhibit empathy, compassion, and integrity to create a better future. Thank you. Marriages have become a happiness, purpose, and boundless success.
I'm sure that my fellow classmates
is calling them to glory.
So God, that is one of the last things we have to do today. But I'm not taking this precious moment for granted. On that note, before we depart, I ask that you keep in mind to never take anything for granted, and that every day of our loved ones, it is not promised. One last thing I want to say before my prayer break to the class of 2023 is that if none of us told you to end in their prayer, then let it be known that I am proud of you. Everyone has overcome the obstacles that we see in these very pretty seats today, and I'm so proud of you receiving this honor, especially the peace of God. Today is your day, and if you don't have any other one of your special day, congratulations to all of us here. God, we pray and pray that we should sign it off. Please welcome the Hopewell High School Mass Choir Director Families to one of our choreographed singing band tonight, followed by the SCA President's News Director, Samantha Thompson. Thank you.
Jamaica. Anthony Lopez Perez. Brooke McKenzie Kinney. Joe Barrow Leeds. K.N. Mary Jane Smith. Jasmine Marie Stewart. Aiden Daniel Bates. Hannah Arizona Bennett. Adriana Lee Carter. Andrea Bailey Claiborne. Anderson, Eugene Lee Coleman. I was to say goodbye to him. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.